nailigtas niya sa atin. Sa pingin sa diwain, pagliligtas niya sa atin.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Nicholas de Tolentino. With humble hearts, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, the light of the faithful and shepherd of souls, who set blessed Nicholas de Tolentino in the church to feed your sheep by his words and form them by his example, grant that through his intercession, we may keep the faith he taught by his words and follow the way he showed by his example. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, how can any one of you with a case against another dare to bring it to the unjust for judgment instead of to the holy ones? Do you not know that the holy ones will judge the world? If not the world is to be judged by you, are you unqualified for the lowest law courts? Do you not know that we will judge angels? Then why not everyday matters? If, therefore, you have courts for everyday matters, do you sit as judges people of no standing in the church? I say this to shame you. Can it be that there is not one among you wise enough to be able to settle a case between brothers, but rather brother goes to church against brother, and that before unbelievers? Now, indeed then it is, in any case, a failure on your part that you have lawsuits against one another. Why not rather put up with injustice? Why not rather let yourselves be cheated? Instead, you inflict injustice and cheat, and this to brothers. Do you not know that the unjust will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor boy prostitutes, nor sodomites, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers, nor robbers will inherit the kingdom of God. That is what some of you used to be, but now you have had yourselves washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and in the Spirit of our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Let them praise His name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to Him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves His people, and He adorns the lowly with victory.
The Lord takes delight in His people.
Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all His faithful. Alleluia.
The Lord takes delight in His people. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus departed to the mountain to pray, and He spent the night in prayer to God. When the day came, He called His disciples to Himself, and from them He chose 12. Whom He also named apostles: Simon, whom He named Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon who was called a Zealot, and Judas the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And He came down with them and stood on a stretch of level ground. A great crowd of His disciples and a large number of the people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon came to hear Him and to be healed of their diseases. And even those who were tormented by unclean spirits were cured. Everyone in the crowd sought to touch Him, because power came forth from Him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
The tone of St. Paul in our first reading today may sound harsh and heavy. Pinagsabihan niya po ang mga taga-Korinto sa mga bagay na tila ay sumablay sila. Paul enumerated a number of them, but towards the end, some grave sins were committed by the said community. Although with a heavy beginning, he ended with a consoling reminder. You were not anymore those kinds of people because Jesus has changed you. You were saved by Jesus, you knew Jesus, and that is why you are new now. You know, such is the effect of a person knowing and encountering Christ. A sinner, a poor person, a neglected person, lowly and not so much of a familiar face as he or she can be. But then Jesus can surely transform him into something new. We've heard the calling, the story of the calling of the apostles, and at least the first encounter of Jesus and his band of apostles with the people around them. Dahil tinawag sila ni Jesus na bago ang kanilang buhay, at madaming mga sumunod kay Jesus, ang nagnais din na mabago din ang kanilang puso. Mabago sila dahil sa pagkakasakit, matungo sila sa kagalingan. Sa pagkalunod sa buhay na ito, to a certain experience of freedom sa ginhawa at sa pagpapala ng Diyos, ang mga turnaround of events na sinasabi nga natin. And my dear brothers and sisters, as we welcome a new day, we welcome this message of inspiration. Every encounter with the Lord is an encounter of change. Kahit ba hindi agad nakikita ang pagbabago sa ating buhay, pero sa kada lapit kay Jesus, sa kada dasal, sa kada simba, sa kada usap natin sa Diyos, hindi na tayo yung dating tayo. Yung may bigat, yung may kasalanan, yung may sablay, dahil tinawag ng Diyos, inilapit tayo ng Diyos, nagbabago tayo, gumagaan tayo, at pinagpapala tayo. Change may not be seen immediately, but we are assured that every time God calls, and every time we are near God, a shift in life comes. Sabi nga po ng isang kapatid na pari, when fire touches the wood, it turns out to be a piece of coal. When fire touches a paper, it turns out to be ashes. But when Jesus touches humanity, when Jesus would touch us, we change, we become better, we are made worthy.
Please stand.
God calls His chosen ones to fulfill His will. Let us pray confidently to our Father, knowing that He wishes His people to intercede for the world. For every petition, we shall all say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church, through the Pope and bishops, may lead us to the fullness of Christian life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That statement may guide our nation to the future stability and development of our nation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may persevere and be faithful in the vocation God has called us to undertake. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the old, the sick, and the lonely may realize God's presence in their trials and difficulties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may rest in the peace of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions. As we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, as we make these prayers, we come to do your will. Accept us in your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We humbly implore your majesty, Almighty God, that just as the offerings made in honor of Blessed Nicholas bear witness to the glory of divine power, so they may impart to us the effects of your salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Nicholas de Tolentino, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Nicholas de Tolentino and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us call on God, our Father. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May the mysteries we have received, O Lord, prepare us, we pray, for the eternal joys that as a faithful steward, Blessed Nicolas de Tolentino came to deserve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpalang ilikha, ipinagpalang